and we have finished our 3 units, and now we are going to enter into a new unit. So before going to enter into the new unit, we will see actually what we are learning in all these 3 units. Okay, so stay with me. Now, first of all, we have read what is life process. Right? So we have seen what is life process. So the process which helps in the survival and perpetuation. Perpetuation in the sense, nothing but the continuation. So the process which helps in the survival and perpetuation of a race is called as life process. It's called as life process. Now, what are the life processes which we have learned till now? In the first unit is the nutrition. Okay? So this nutrition, that is, if you don't take the nutrients, if you don't take the nutrients, you will die. That means you have to take the nutrients, and nutrients will help you to survive. If you don't take the nutrients, definitely there are chances that you will die. You will not survive. So this nutrients are helping. Nutrition is a process, is a life process which is helping in your survival. That's the first thing. Second thing we have seen is the photosynthesis. Now, how come photosynthesis will become a life process? Because if there is no process called as photosynthesis, there will be no food on the earth. The organisms cannot survive and they will die because of the lack of food. So, and the food, like, because it is scarce in the earth, all the organisms, you know, like, they completely, directly or indirectly, they depend upon the plants, right, which perform the process called as the photosynthesis, and automatically all these organisms will die. So that is how photosynthesis is also helping in our survival. So we have to put this process also under the life process. And the next one we have learned here is the digestion. So we have learned that if there is no process called as digestion, if the digestion doesn't occur, what will happen? Right? The person will definitely die, because all the waste will be accumulated in the body. Okay, if the digestion is not happening, the particles will not be broken down into small particles, and they will never go into the blood and never go into the cells and tissues, and that is how all the cells and tissues will not get the energy, all the organs will not get the energy to perform, right? The heart is beating, that means it requires energy, isn't it? So each and every organism, each and every organ of the body requires energy. So that's only possible if there is nutrition. Okay, if there is a process called photosynthesis, if there is specially the process which is called as the digestion, only if there is digestion, if all these things are broken down and energy is produced, then only a person can survive. Otherwise, he will die because of the lack of food. Next, we have seen is the respiration. How come respiration becomes a life process here? Because if you don't respire, you will definitely die. A very simple thing, that if you don't respire, you will die. If the oxygen doesn't go into the blood, if the oxygen is not sent into the tissues and cells and all, so definitely the person will die because of the lack of oxygen. So oxygen is also helping you to survive. And the next thing we have seen is the circulation. Next thing is what we have seen is the circulation. So circulation is also helping you to survive, right? Because what are the things which are, right, you know, produced by the digestion process, that is glucose, amino acids, fatty acids, and whatever it is, that all these things, you know, like, and even vitamins and minerals and all, you know, like, all these things now should be sent to the cells, right? And what is the oxygen which you take, again, that should be sent to the cell. So there should be a proper transport system to transport all these things. So if there is no proper transport system, how all they will go to the cells? Because cells, if the cells are alive, we will be alive. If the cells die, we will die. So that's how we have to be, we have to transport all these things to different parts of the body. So our heart will do that, right? That's the reason why we have learned about the circulation. So these are the different processes which we have learned in the process which is called as the life process, under the part survival. Okay, so now we are going to start a new unit today. We are going to start a new unit today, and this unit is very important, okay, for the examinations, okay, in the view of examinations. And this is absolutely very important. Three major questions comes from this lesson, that is 4 marks questions come from this lesson, and writing those answers is really dead easy if you follow. If you don't follow, then we can't help you anymore. So if you follow, definitely you will be able to score 4 out of 4 in the long questions and 2 out of 2 in the short questions. Or if it comes in the 1 mark question also, you can score the good marks in all. So that is how this questions are linked up. And now we'll see what is a chapter and what we are going to learn from this particular chapter or unit. Now we'll take the example of a factory, right, where different things are produced. For example, we'll take a factory, okay, or an industry where some leather bags are produced. Now, do you think the leather is produced without any waste? Okay, then you take the refineries where oil is produced, right, like the diesel, petrol, okay, all by using the crude oil and all. So do you think it is produced without any waste? Even the food which you cook in the home also, you will see there are something waste, right? You throw something as waste, and then your own, the edible part will be different, and there'll be wastage, right? So everything, whatever you do, there'll be a wastage, right? From industries to the food which you eat in your home also, there is something which is absolutely waste and which is not useful, right? In the same way, our body also functions a lot of activities. Our body also functions a lot of activities which are very important for our body. And when these activities are performed, there are some wastes which are generated. And these wastes, you know, like, they are to be eliminated outside. They should not be in the body. Okay. So this is one of the things which I want to tell you. So now, if I say the wastes are produced, then the next question arises that where they are produced, who will produce these wastes, how they are formed, and how they are produced, how they are formed, and is the composition same, do like each and every organ produces a waste, like, you know, if the waste is produced, how it is sent out. So number of questions, like, you know, they will be attached to this particular sentence. Now for this, we need to understand two words. There are two processes takes place in our body, right? The first one is called as the anabolism. Second one is catabolism. So first one is the anabolism, second one is the catabolism. Anabolism is building up the materials. So something which you are building, you are joining them, you are making into something which is useful to our body, right? So building up anything is called as the anabolism, and breaking down is called as the catabolism. So these are the processes which continuously happens in our body, right? There will be anabolism in our body, proteins will be built up, right? The amino acids will join together to become proteins and all. Okay, so there are several substances which they'll be built up, like, you know, the muscles should be built up, so the protein should act on that, the protein should join together so that the muscles will be developed. So this kind of anabolism will be definitely taking place in our body. Second thing is breaking down. That is, now if the food material doesn't break down, they cannot enter into the blood. So whatever the food you eat, right, that is not going to directly give you the energy. That is not going to build your body. That is not going to build your muscle. That is not going to heal your wounds, right? So whatever it is, that they are not going to happen if these are not broken down. If they are not broken down into small particles so that they can dissolve in the blood and send to the different cells and tissues of the body, till then you will not see any kind of energy being generated. So what happens here is breaking down of particles are very much needed here. So the building up, breaking up, that means the anabolism and catabolism together, we call it as a metabolism. We call it as metabolism. So now these are the metabolic activities, right? So that means now you just assume that your body will be continuously doing the anabolic activities and the catabolic activities. In other words, you can say that they will be undergoing lot of metabolic activities. So metabolic activities are very, very common in our body, and they will be going on and going on without any kind of leisure and all. So organisms, they use different substances in our body for these metabolic activities, and for digestion, for excretion, for respiration and water, for each and every process which takes place in our body, lot of metabolism has to be done. Lot of metabolic activities has to be taken place. Okay, children. So like this, because of these metabolic activities in our body, lot of waste materials will be produced. Now just assume, take a plant. Do you think plant will not excrete anything which is not necessary for them? Take an animal will also eliminate something which is not useful to its body. If you take the human body also, they'll eliminate some things which are not useful to our body. So each and every animal organism will try to eliminate the things which are not useful to their body, and if they are in the body, they will become poisonous and that will harm the organism. So that's why they will eliminate it. So now to eliminate them from the body, there should be a separate life process. There should be some separate organs who can eliminate these things from our body. So what is that process? What is that life process? And the life process is that is excretion. So the new unit we are going to study is the excretion, and in this excretion we are going to learn a lot of things. Absolutely, you have to concentrate as you have concentrated in the circulation topic, and in the same way here also in the excretion also you need to concentrate a lot. Now we'll try to see few examples. Okay, now by this you will come to an understanding. Now, what are these excreted products? Who will produce them? Why they need to be excreted? All those things we are going to see. And before that, we are going to see some examples. Okay. So now, the first process we talk about is the photosynthesis. Right? In the photosynthesis, what you can see is they use the carbon dioxide plus water, okay, and they will, in the presence of the chlorophyll and also the sunlight, what they try to do is they will try to build up the materials. They'll undergo a process called as anabolism, okay, and they will produce the carbohydrate, that is the glucose. The glucose is produced at the same time. See, they are taking the carbon dioxide and water, and they are producing the glucose. At the same time, what they leave out? They leave out the oxygen and also water, which are the excretory material, right? Which are not useful for the plant at that particular time. So whatever is extra in them, whatever is the, which are extra in them, they will utilize the glucose. But whatever the excess amount of water is there, it will send them out. What the excess amount of oxygen is there, that will be sent, it will be eliminated, it will be excreted from the body of the plant, right? So here, in the process of photosynthesis, they are using the carbon dioxide and water, and they are building the glucose, right? And also they are excreting the oxygen and the water. So now this glucose is very, very important for each and every organism for their future use. If there is no glucose production, if the plant doesn't undergo the photosynthesis process, now you cannot even imagine the organisms living on the earth. Now coming to this oxygen, now the human beings, and in the process called as respiration, what the organisms do is they will use this oxygen, and what they gives out is the carbon dioxide, And this carbon dioxide, if it stays in organism for a longer time, there is a chance of the death of the person. Not chance, but definitely the person will die because of the lack of oxygen. So now this carbon dioxide will become the excretory product in the human being. So oxygen is taken by the human beings, but what is given out? Carbon dioxide is given. Again, this carbon dioxide is again taken by the plants and they give out the oxygen. So this is the process, right? But still, whatever the processes are here, they are producing some waste materials. Okay, right? Now coming to the digestion. Now in the digestion, organisms will take the food. Do you think the complete food will be used by the body? Whatever the food which you are taking, for example, you have taken some mutton or a chicken or some rice or dal or whatever it is. So do you think whatever you have eaten will be converted to food in your, will be converted to energy in your body? I don't think so. The complete food, it is not converted to food in our body, but whereas there will be lot of waste material, okay, which is waste material which is formed in the body and it need to be eliminated outside. Though digestion, in the process of digestion, you are getting the glucose, amino acids and fatty acids, but still there are some waste materials which are being formed here which are not useful to our body, and our body becomes toxic, our body becomes they become poisonous, if they stay in our body for a long time. So that is how these things should be eliminated from the body. These things should be excreted from the body, and that is the reason why we have a special organ system which is called as the excretory system, or else, and the process what they do is called as the excretion. So what we are going to learn in this lesson, we are going to learn a lot of things. Even if you can take the example of the water you drink, right? Water you drink. So, and the you talk also about the blood which you have in the body. So these are different things, urine also is an excretory material. Water is an excretory material from our body. Even the blood also has lot of excretory substance in our body. Okay, so whatever the things are there, whatever the waste materials are there, they need to be eliminated outside. So if you take the blood, and blood will carry the oxygen, you know what it brings back? It brings back the carbon dioxide. What is carbon dioxide? Carbon dioxide is absolutely poisonous gas. It's a poisonous gas, and this poisonous gas will completely kill the person if it is in the body. So that is the reason why they go to the lungs and immediately eliminate the carbon dioxide, and again it will replace the oxygen back. So that is how this process will continuously go on. So all the waste materials will be eliminated, and what are the things which are needed will be retained. So in this unit, we are going to learn lot of things about, especially about the excretory system and the process which is called as the excretion. That is the reason why I insist you to, now this is only introductory part, right? Hardly we have come to one page, right? No, half of one page maximum. We have completed the page number 74. Okay, so this is only an introduction part, and tomorrow onwards we'll go ahead with the actual part of the lesson. And now I want you to write the different processes which you have learned till now, and you need to write what are the waste material, what are the products actually formed, and also what are the waste products which are formed. So all these things you just write in a paper and post them in the group. Okay, so children, that's all for today. Take care. Have a great day. See you all. See you tomorrow. Have a great day. Bye.